Now, I can't get too specific into the details, but in this video, I will talk about what my experiences as a canvasser has been kind of been like. I've only been a canvasser for 3 weeks, so there's not really that much to say, but it has been quite an experience. I think I've changed in a lot of ways just in the course of 3 weeks, and those 3 weeks felt really long, at least the first 2 weeks. The most recent week went by pretty quickly, but those 2 weeks were really transformative. So, you know, I'll just talk a little bit about that. This isn't my first time canvassing, actually. I did it two years ago, but only for 4 days. That was when, again, I was unemployed, just like how it was this year. I was looking for something. I saw on Craigslist, so it was like, hey, call this number. And, you know, those are kind of like the best things when you're job searching phone numbers. There's not many jobs that allow you to actually call them. A lot of jobs ask you to, you know, email your resume and cover letter, and you wait for weeks for an answer that you might not get, and then after that you get interviewed, and then you wait for weeks for an answer that you might not get. That's usually how the hiring process goes for, like, even a lot of the entry-level jobs. The only time it doesn't really happen like that is with, like, super minimum wage jobs. I mean, canvassing is kind of a minimum wage job, so but the first one I did wasn't minimum wage. It was like $10 an hour, so that was quite surprising. But yeah, canvassing is one of those things. You call that number, and the person, like, you know, if the person likes you, which is quite easy to do, you just have a friendly conversation, and the person is like, yeah, these are the causes we are fighting for. Are you interested? It's like, yeah. Well, come in 6 o'clock tonight. It's like, whoa, what? That's crazy. So you get interviewed on the same day. At the same, well, two years ago, that was total shock to me. I wasn't even ready for anything. I wanted to go in my interview clothes, and I hadn't done my laundry. So I was just like, well, actually, how about some other time? And she's like, okay, come tomorrow morning. Again, a sudden shock, but yeah, I went the morning after. I was dressed in suits, but of course you don't really need to be dressed in interview clothes when going for an interview for canvassing job. Just business casual, like this shirt without a tie is totally fine. I went, talked with the person, and I wrote this like application, whatever, and like that was pretty much it, and I was hired. So that was amazing. Like the canvassing, you can call, and on that very same day, you can be hired. That's pretty unheard of in a lot of jobs. I mean, there are those fields out there, you know. I mean, I guess you could do the same thing, like for a bartender. You could probably call the bar or go to the bar and be like, hey, you're looking for a bartender? Awesome, hire me. And then if the person likes you, you'll probably be hired on the spot. But I don't know, in the nonprofit world, this is kind of rare. So that was exciting. And then I was a street canvasser, so it was mostly like standing in the middle of the streets, and people would pass by, and the goal is to, you know, the purpose of the job is to kind of, hey, like stop them with a warm, friendly wave and talk to them about the cause and get them involved, you know, share information about what's going on with this issue. When I was a street canvasser, I canvassed on behalf of ASPCA, American Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. So, you know, it's a very famous organization, so that was actually quite easy to canvass for. The most difficult thing at the time was that the canvassing organization didn't have license to canvass in New York. So we were going to New Jersey for street canvassing, and the weather was brutal. It was super, super cold. 2 years ago, winter in the East Coast was pretty brutal. So our hands were freezing. We would take these like hand warmer packets, whatever, and we would just waste them so quickly. We would take like 6 per person, and by the third hour into canvassing, we'd be down to 2. And you know, but it was really hard. Not a lot of street traffic or, you know, walking traffic in New Jersey, the places we went to. So I had to be really good, which, you know, I'm not. I don't think I'm still. Even if I tried street canvassing now, I don't think I'd be that good. Even now, even after all I've learned from door-to-door canvassing for 3 weeks. Actually, 2 weeks, because my first week, like I said, I only worked two days. But yeah, it's a different kind of skill set than what I'm used to. You know, I'm very good with like one-on-one communication with the clients. You know, I'm very empathetic, and you know, this polite way of doing things. I'm a great writer. I can organize things well. But canvassing is a whole different game. You gotta have this like charming aura about you and confidence, which, I mean, that's still something I struggle with. You know, being able to like just be out there, assertive, get people to get excited just by seeing you and talking to you. That is challenging, and that's why street canvassing didn't work out for me. I have to make the team, so there's a certain amount of money that I have to raise. So these are like the observation day periods where, like I said, I can't go into too much detail, but observation days are pretty much, hey, you have some amount of days where in that one day you have to raise a certain amount of money, and if you don't, 3 days in a row, then you don't make the team or staff, and that's what happened with me. You know, I wasn't able to make that fundraising requirement. But it was great 4 days. I had a lot of fun, even with the brutal winter. The great thing about canvassing is that when you're with canvassing with the crew, there's a lot of camaraderie. You know, the people that you work with them like side by side for so long. You know, you develop this bond, and you're always encouraging each other to do better. Like, it's a very supportive work environment, and that is what's awesome about one of the most awesome things about canvassing. Other than, you know, the most awesome thing is of course meeting strangers and getting them interested in this cause, and learning that they can be so generous. Well, my first 4 days it was hard. You know, it was hard to actually get people to stop. That's what I need as a street canvasser, that charming aura to, you know, busy people walking past me, and I have to be able to be like, hey, how's it going? And they would stop to talk to me. But that's hard. Right now I'm door-to-door canvassing, so I'm knocking on strangers' doors. So that's actually more my forte. You know, I don't have the ability to have people stop. And I'm very patient, you know. And that's one thing that the door-to-door canvasser needs, good patience. And politeness and respect. So those are my strengths. So this works out. And yeah. So that's what's great. You know, I knock and I wait. I ring. I wait and people come. You know, and we talk. It's always I rarely have like really negative experiences. Those usually happen around nighttime. You know, people don't want to be bothered at night, which is totally understandable. So far it's been a great experience. You know, I've been learning to be more confident. All my other jobs, you know, I go to job on time or, you know, early. I do my hours. As long as I follow the company rules and do what I'm supposed to do, it's good. I'm safe. It's safe. I come back home and that's it. But canvassing is performance-based or merit-based. So I actually, not only do I have to like just work at the way I'm supposed to, but work, like produce, yield good results. So this like fundraising requirement, that the amount of money I would have to raise, it continues. It's past observation day. I have to keep raising that amount of money to keep my job pretty much. So that's the challenging thing. Is to keep producing results. It's a very merit-based salary and job security, which is amazing. It's like the most. I feel like this is the most capitalistic realm of the nonprofit world. This was because a lot of times we talk about the money we raise. I think we talk about money a lot more than like for-profit security, like private firms or corporate firms. Which is interesting because we're a nonprofit organization, but yeah, no, I've developed a lot of self confidence. I've been improving a lot. Really, I'm learning a lot of important skills, I think. Also, another important thing is being able to respond properly when a lot of people get a stranger knocking on their door. You know, they don't want to be bothered, you know, which, again, totally understandable. And, you know, they don't want to talk, they don't want to get involved, they don't know what you're doing. So there's a lot of resistances to people. And understanding that and responding to that properly, that was hard. And persuading a no into a yes in terms of involvement and contribution, we need that skill. Because getting, you know, finding people who are already on board with On the Cause, currently I'm canvassing for the Human Rights Campaign, which is the nation's largest LGBT civil rights group. So finding people who are on board with, gay rights and people who are willing to get involved in that just from the start, it's pretty rare. Those are gems. A lot of times I'll get people who are, you know, with me on the issue, but I need that energy to kind of push them. And that's what I really struggled with the first week. First week I made team by being kind of really lucky. There were, like, I met two people who were already on board, and I talked with them, and then, you know, they had no resistance, and I got super lucky with the amount of money I was able to raise. But the next day, of course, because that day was luck, the next day went horribly, you know? The important skill of a canvasser is that being able to respond properly and having a great energy around you that makes people want to talk to you and want to get involved with the issue. So that is something that, been challenging the first week. Now I've gotten a lot better. I'm still, like, I feel like among the crew, I still feel like I'm the weakest link a lot of the times. But that's probably because there's another full-timer besides me. It's a pretty recent, this campaign, this canvassing office started recently, so very recently. So we don't have a lot of staff yet, so there's only like one other full-time staff. And he's amazing. He started around the same time as me. He's an amazing canvasser. Like, he does a lot, sometimes, a lot of times actually, he yields results better than our assistant director and our director. So working alongside him has been amazing. He's really supportive. He helps me a lot. I learned so much from him. But at the same time, it's just like he's doing so well and I'm doing like just kind of okay. It just makes me think like, man, you know, I don't know if I'm actually cut out for this. But, you know, I made it 3 weeks and now I'm going to Colorado for a different cause. A cause that is going to be pretty important. Not necessarily because I believe fully in it, you know, I'm going to be campaigning for the Obama campaign so that he would win the election. I'm not a huge, huge supporter of Obama, but not a supporter of Romney at all. So that's why I'm doing it. It's going to be fun. It's going to be interesting. I hope that I'm able to continue doing well and better at canvassing. So that when I make a next video about canvassing or something, it would be like, so I've now worked as a canvasser for 6 months, and share that, you know, because 3 weeks is, it feels long, but it's really isn't. It's only 3 weeks, you know. So, yeah.